make you happy. And if you say, hey, go away, I will. But I think better still, I'd better stay around and love you. Do you think I have a case? Let me ask you to your face. Do you think you love me?
Fun.
Must have been. I feel guilty.
Simone, will you stop squirming? What's the matter with you? Why'd you feel guilty?
For not rehearsing. Maybe if we went over that new song a couple more times this afternoon, we can put it in our opening tomorrow.
Oh, my gosh.
What's the matter, Laurie?
Look, I don't want anyone to panic or anything, but there's a skunk sitting right behind me.
A what, dear?
A skunk, Mother.
Don't look at me.
Skunk, honey.
Ooh, that smell is absolutely gross.
Very unpleasant, but at least he's gone now.
Yeah, but I have a feeling he's going to be with us in spirit for a long time to come.
Did you have to do that? I'm going to end up smelling like a girl.
Listen, you should be so lucky. Anyway, anything's better than skunk.
I don't know. At least skunk has a masculine smell.
Okay, kids. Welcome to Mae West's boudoir.
Ooh?
Just get in. I just used up a whole bottle of my best perfume. Doesn't it smell any better?
No, just different.
What do you mean?
Now it smells like perfume skunk.
We're just going to have to live with it until we get to the hotel, and then we can take a bath and change. Thank goodness we don't have to open until tomorrow. Give us a chance to get our stuff fumigated.
Simone in the bus until we can get her shampoo.
Poor Simone, she'll be lonely.
Honey, the way she smells, she'll be lonely wherever she goes.
Well, how are we going to get through the lobby smelling like this?
We'll just have to brazen it through. Everyone stick close together and don't get near any of the other guests. Let's go.
I don't think that's going to be too much of a problem.
Do you have our suite ready?
Yes. Would you like to register?
I don't think we should come any closer.
Oh?
You see, we've had this rather unfortunate accident.
Accident?
We don't smell very good.
Could you just throw me the key, please?
Yes. I don't think that would be within regulations, madam.
Why don't you just place it on the desk and back away?
Sure.
A skunk stowed away in our bus.
I see. There's a message for you, Mrs. Partridge.
Oh, no.
What's it say?
Arranged benefit performance this evening at 7 o'clock. We'll arrive shortly and explain. Reuben.
7 o'clock? We'll never be cleaned up and ready by then.
We'll just have to get out of it. Could you tell us where our room is, please? I don't think we'll need a bellboy.
Well, I could call for volunteers.
Won't be necessary.
15th floor, suite 1506.
Thank you. Oh, and you don't have to worry. We'll all be taking baths very shortly.
Sure.
is it's that bad?
It's a mixture between skunk and ladies' cologne.
Don't bottle it. It'll never sell. Look, would you mind taking the elevator up yourselves?
I'm terribly sorry about driving all your passengers away.
That's okay, lady. Just keep it moving. Otherwise, this elevator will be classified as a pollution area. No offense.
Sure. I'll send you a free ticket for tomorrow night's performance.
Terrific. Make it in the back of the room.
Okay. Nobody touch anything. Stand perfectly still.
Can we even sit down?
No, you'll contaminate the chairs. Laurie and Tracy use the bath and the shower in there. Chris, Danny use the other bathroom. Put your socks, shoes, and clothes in the hamper. We'll bury them later. Everyone else stand perfectly still until it's your turn to shower.
Can I sit on the suitcase?
Okay. Keep your feet off the floor.
You know, it's weird, but I can still smell that stuff.
Well, it's probably your imagination.
I have a pretty powerful imagination.
No, I think it got inside our nostrils.
That's one part I forgot to wash.
Oh, it's good to be clean again. You hold on a minute, I'll get you some clothes.
I'll get it. Oh, hi, Mr. Kincaid.
Yeah. Hey, what's going on in here? I asked the desk clerk downstairs if I could come up. He asked me if I had a strong stomach.
Oh, Reuben, it's a long story. What's this about a benefit tonight?
Oh, I couldn't refuse, Shirley. It's at a children's hospital, and the kids all play your records, and when they phoned, I just didn't have the heart to turn them down. Why aren't you ready?
I don't think we're going to be able to make it.
We're due there at 7 o'clock. I can't cancel now.
Yeah, we can't disappoint them now, Mom.
Well, if we hurry, we can still make it.
I would have told you sooner, but you were on the road, and I didn't have it. Excuse me, but did you know there's a terrible smell in here?
Smell? Oh, it can't be anymore. What kind of smell?
I don't know. The whole place smells of freshly washed skunk.
Can I bite into your cup?
And hold our noses and ears at the same time.
We can't go into a hospital smelling of skunk.
At least it's clean skunk.
There's no such thing. Anyway, it wouldn't be fair for us to walk in like this. After all, they're a captive audience.
These kids would be heartbroken.
I don't understand it. We've scrubbed until our skins are raw.
What do you use?
What do you mean? Soap and water.
Tomato juice.
Tomato juice?
Only thing that'll get rid of it. Now, room service, please.
Reuben, are you sure?
Have it from a very reliable source.
Who?
I forget. Something about the ingredients of tomato juice. Hello, room service. This is suite 1506. Would you please send up, 40 large cans of tomato juice.
40 cans?
That's right, 40 cans. I realize you don't usually send it up in cans, but this is an emergency. Well, what do you care what kind of emergency? Well, all right. All right. We have a whole family up here who are stinking. No, they do not want to make Bloody Marys. Look, if you must know, they want to take a bath in it. Very funny fella. Just send up the cans. Because it cuts the smell of skunk. Okay. Okay. I just send it up in glasses. Well, how do I know how many glasses? Enough to fill a bathtub. No, we do not need any ice.
Sir? Where do you want it?
Oh, in the bathtub.
There goes 20 bucks.
What?
Room service bet me 20 bucks you were going to take a bath in it. Naturally, we took the bet. Now it's beginning to smell like a setup to me.
Really? Is that what it smells like to you?
No, actually, it smells like skunk.
Right. This tomato juice is going to get rid of that smell. Get it?
Got it.
Good. Now, would you do as I ask?
You know, I just thought of something.
What?
What if they end up smelling of tomatoes instead?
Okay, go sit with the clean group.
How do you feel, Daddy?
As if somebody should salt and pepper me.
Are you clean?
Well, it's pretty hard to raise a lather with that stuff.
Chris, you're next.
I don't want to wash in history tomatoes.
Come on, get in there. How are we doing on time?
The hospital's only 10 minutes away. We should make it.
We won't be able to perform in costume. We'll have to wear what's in these suitcases.
Well, I don't think the kids at the hospital will mind.
Tracy, you wear... Oh, there it is again.
There's one again.
Can't you smell it?
I can smell it. It's coming in the case.
Close it up, Mom. Close it up.
It's all over our clothes.
But don't you have some more clothes in the bus?
If these are contaminated, they're going to be, too. What are we going to do?
Why don't we follow the trend?
What are you talking about?
Perform topless.
That'll only solve half our problem.
Well, I'm game to go the whole way.
We already have enough comedy in the act.
All right, kids, knock it off. This is no time to be funny.
Look, there must be some clothing stores here in the hotel.
They'll be closed.
There may be some stores in town still open.
There isn't time for that, Laurie.
Now, wait a minute. Hold it, everybody. Let's not panic. Let me think. I got an extra set of clothes here. I can wear these.
Great. But what about the other five of us?
We'll just have to borrow some.
Who's going
to
lend us clothes in the next 5 minutes?
I'll think of somebody. But I'll need some help. But Keith, are you still polluted?
Yeah, but I wish you wouldn't put it like that.
It'll just have to be you, Danny. Here, put these on.
What do you want me to do?
Charm the pants off people.
You in private?
What for?
I have a proposition to make.
I don't date midgets.
I'll bet you're a perfect size 10.
I beg your pardon?
Oh. Oh, look, I know this may sound unusual, but could I rent your dress for one night?
I'm not sure this is your color.
Look, I don't have time to tell you the whole story. I'll give you $15 to rent your outfit for a couple of hours, okay?
Okay, but answer me one thing. How come you're wearing clothes 10 sizes too big for you?
Would you believe when I started the day I was 6 feet tall?
You gonna mail it to me, kid, or what? Should I come back?
Now, you all go over there by cab, and I'll drive the bus over with the equipment.
Why can't we all go by bus?
Because you're sterile. You get in the bus, you'll be contaminated again. Come on.
Well, won't you get to smell bad?
Sometimes managers have to make sacrifices. St. Mark's Hospital, please. See you later.
You the Partridge family?
Yes.
I got something for you.
Oh!
What's the matter? Isn't he your dog? I saw him in your bus and he looked lonely.
But didn't you notice anything unusual about him?
Unusual?
He's been in direct contact with a skunk.
Oh, well, I wouldn't know about that because, you see, I got this terrible cold.
Now what, Mom? We have to get to the hospital.
How?
I guess we'll have to bribe the driver.
How are we going to get into a hospital smelling like this?
I'll think of something.
Watch us be facing the crowd. You can remember that once upon a love affair. Your heart was warm, your lips were tender.